today is the fourth day of the seventh month on our Maker's restored calendar. It is the 28th day of August on his servant Satan's calendar. Today I'm going to share some very, very powerful evidence with you that testifies to the very, very real possibility that the Yellowstone caldera will begin to blow forth just 6 days from today. If this is the case, a great earthquake will shake the earth at 7:34 a.m. according to Arizona time that will cause this event to begin to happen. 6 days from today is the Most High's restored Day of Atonement. This special day will be the five smooth stone anniversary of his Day of Atonement on his restored calendar. It will also be the one smooth stone anniversary of the day that Yahweh my Elohim caused his Azazel goat to blow the shofar from his holy mountain in fulfillment of his Joel chapter 2:1 prophecy. In the one smooth stone and a sure sling video, I said, let me put it this way. I cannot think of another hugely important event that Yahweh caused his servant to do last year, other than this one, that would set up another such one smooth stone scenario during this five smooth stone year. When I spoke this, I was referring to the one smooth stone anniversary of the 14th day of the 12/14 days that he caused his end time son of Adam to write his truce upon the whitewashed boulder design of his house. The Most High obviously closed my dual eyes from being able to see this one smooth stone anniversary of his fulfillment of Joel 2:1 when I spoke this. Yahweh caused his servant David to take five smooth stones with him in his shepherd's bag that day when he went forth to smite Goliath. And Yahweh caused his servant to only need to use one of them to get the job done. This special day of covering will fall on September 3rd on his servant Satan's calendar. Here is another reason why I believe that there is a very, very real possibility that this is the day that our Maker will begin to shake the dual heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land. Not only is it the one smooth stone anniversary of his fulfillment of Joel 2:1, and not only does it bring forth the 10th day that is the next day, it also brings forth an amazing 188-day scenario that would be a spectacular finish to the 188-day earthquake cycle that Yahweh set forth at the time that he was plucking me from your midst at the beginning of him sending me to you. At that time, the Almighty set forth five great earthquakes that many people were amazed at. These great quakes were spaced 188 and one-half days apart on average, depending upon the time zones that they were in. Many people knew that these five quakes were an amazing end-time sign. These earthquakes and the timing of them are discussed in more detail in other videos. However, I will give you a brief summary of each of them. The first of them was on 2/27/2010 on his servant Satan's calendar. Yahweh opened the door of the three tiers of the ark on 2/27 on his calendar. This quake was an 8.8 that Yahweh sent upon the inhabitants of Concepcion, Chile. This was the sixth largest earthquake ever recorded by a seismograph. The statistics that the Most High wove into each of these quakes are amazing. For instance, with this one, 525 people were killed and 25 were not found. This was 550 people that were killed. This parallels the Most High's Isaiah 55:11 signature ring that he's put upon my hand and the dual 550-day periods that he wove into his end-time timeline during the beginning of him sending me to you. The 25 missing people parallels his recent 25-day countdown from the great American eclipse that he recently sent across a 70-mile swath of this great Elohim-like city of America. Concepcion means Immaculate Conception. The second of these five quakes was a 7.0 that Yahweh sent upon the inhabitants of Christchurch, New Zealand, on the fourth day of the ninth month on his servant Satan's calendar, 7 years ago in 2010. The name Christchurch speaks for itself. Yahweh's word calls your churches that you play the whore to him in, whorehouses. The seventh day from this year's Day of Atonement is another very special day at Yahweh's end time timeline. I spoke about some of its significance in the last video, and I will touch upon it again here in this video in a bit. It is the 17th day of this seventh month. These dual quakes being sent in 2010 parallel these last 20/10 days that I spoke about in the last video as well. The fourth day of the ninth month on his servant Satan's calendar will be the 10th day that was spoken about in the last video. It follows his Day of Atonement. The fourth day of the ninth month on the Most High's calendar is the day that his word gives to us for his Zechariah chapter 7 prophecy that has some amazing prophecies for the here and the now in it. The third 188-day quake of this great earthquake cycle was a 9.0 that the Most High sent forth off the coast of Sendai, Japan on 3/11/2011 on his servant Satan's calendar. This 9.0 parallels the 9 months that it takes to bring forth the man-child. Yahweh's dual 9-month countdowns are discussed in the last video as well. The first of them comes to an end on the 10th day from his memorial of acclamations that is on 9/4 on his servant Satan's calendar. The second of these overlapping 270-day periods comes to an end 10 days later on the last great day of his Feast of Ingathering. The first date that Yahweh sent me forth with was the 10th day of the 10th month. This was on January 15, 2011 on his servant Satan's calendar. This date was given in a video that was called January 15, 2011. In this video, I discussed These Are the Truths, Chapter 7, verses 9 and 10 that tell us the following. Know this, because Yahweh Elohim, He is Elohim, the faithful Elohim that hedges about His covenant and His favor to 1,000 generations with them that love Him, referring to them that love His righteousness, and hedge about His commandments. And He will recompense or make it good to them that hate Him, that hate His righteousness, to their faces, to destroy them. He will not refrain from recompensing those that hate Him. He will recompense them to their faces. Sendai means 1,000 generations. 55 days after this video, Yahweh sent the 9.0 quake off the coast of 1,000 generations, Japan. Most of you know about the damage that the tsunami that resulted from this quake caused, and it is still causing damage with the oceans of the earth dying off from all of the radiation that was released as a result of it hitting Fukushima. The 10th day of the 10th month, when this video went forth, is the day that Yahweh empowered his servant Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, to pitch against Jerusalem. It is also the day that he gave to us for his 5-point Ezekiel sign that is his promise to us that he has sent me to you. He gives us the 5 points of this sign in his chapter 24 End Time Son of Adam prophecy that is also his melting pot Scum of Israel prophecy. Speaking of a melting pot, the origin of the word Caldera is this. It came from the late 17th century and a Spanish word that came from the Latin word Caldaria. Caldaria means a boiling pot. Perhaps this is just a coincidence as well. The fourth 188-day quake was a 7.3 that Yahweh sent forth off the coast of the Lauru Islands on 9/15/2011 on his servant Satan's calendar. The Lauru Islands are a chain of about 100 islands that cover an area of 188 square miles of landmass. 9/15 of this year, 6 years later, will be the 8th day Sabbath that follows Yahweh's 7-day Feast of Temporary Dwellings. This will be the first day of the 7 days of the 7 vials of the 7th trumpet. Yahweh stamped his announcement that Saul of Tarsus is the abomination of desolation with this quake and with his Isaiah chapter 55 signature ring and with a comet that he caused to be named YU-55 that whizzed by the earth at that time. He did so in relation with the timing of the anniversary of the day of my birth on his servant Satan's calendar. The details of him doing so are discussed in another video or two. This is indeed all coming together in a fascinating way. The reason why the Most High used 188 and one half days with this earthquake cycle is because there are 188 and one half days that encompass the time that we are to eat his Passover memorial and the last great day of his Feast of Ingathering, aka his Feast of Huts, aka his Feast of Temporary Dwellings, on his restored calendar. Also, there is this parallel. 20 times 188 is 3,760. Yahweh brought forth his only begotten Son into the world in the year 3760. He brought Yeshua into the world on his memorial of acclamations, that is, on the first day of the seventh month. This year, this day of acclamations brought forth the final 20 days of this dual year period of time that will end on the last great day of the feast. There are 2,188 days that encompass the day of this fourth quake and the 17th day of this seventh month on the Most High's restored calendar. The 17th day of the seventh month was the 40th day that his servant Elijah was upon his holy mountain at Horeb. It is also the day that his word tells us that he marked his servant Noah. This day will host the 777th petition to him upon his holy mountain. The significance of this day at this time is it is a very real possibility that the Most High is going to cause my faces to shine on this day. The fifth quake that Yahweh sent forth was a 7.4 magnitude. He sent forth this 7.4 earthquake 84 miles from Jalapan de Leon, Mexico, on 3/20/2012 on his servant Satan's calendar. Jalapan de Leon, or however you pronounce it, means a place of brave people. His reference to 84 should not need any explanation for those of you that have watched other videos with how the 84 days tie into the here and the now and the death and the resurrection of Yahweh's second anointed son. The last great day of his Feast of Ingathering brings forth the end of the final 84-day period of this dual year period of time. This is discussed in other videos. This quake happening this distance from a place of brave people had huge significance in lieu of what I was talking about in the videos at that time. I was speaking about Abraham leaving his kindred when he was told to do so, and him trusting and obeying his Elohim. There were 800 homes that were destroyed in one town alone from this quake, yet there was not a single life that was lost. How is that possible? The other four quakes caused large numbers of casualties. I saw one picture where a bridge had collapsed upon a semi-truck, and it looked like there was no possible way that the driver could have survived. Yahweh's deliverance of the people in this quake is symbolic of the deliverance that he is going to give to those that are brave enough to put their trust in his word and obey his voice and flee to his holy mountain like he has commanded us to do. An earthquake that did this much damage over an area of 200 miles without the loss of a single life is indeed symbolic of a great supernatural deliverance. It takes not only courage to put our trust in Elohim's word and not in our own arm, it also takes believing his word. Abraham exhibited his belief in Yahweh when he left his kindred to obey Yahweh and to pursue after him. Genesis chapter 15 verse 6 tells us that Abraham believed Yahweh and he accredited it to him as righteousness. His word tells us that all unbelievers are going to be burnt up in the lake that burns with fire and brimstone. If you do not believe that he has sent me, you do not believe his word, period. He has fulfilled volumes of his prophecies to testify to the fact that he has sent me to you. These four destructive quakes becoming a fifth of this series, and it being different than the four without the loss of a single life, is yet another parallel to the fifth day of the fourth month. It just so happens that this year's Day of Atonement will be 188 and one half days after the first day of the first month on his restored calendar. The first day of the first month is a huge day in the testimony of his word. It is the day that Yahweh caused his servant Noah to remove the covering from the three tiers of the ark. It is the day that Yahweh caused his servant Moses to rear up the tent of his appointed times in the wilderness in the second year. It is the first of the dual dates that his word gives to us for his end-time son of Adam cleansing his sanctuary at this time. It is one of the four dates that his word gives to us for the opening wide of his end-time son of Adam's mouth. He gives us this prophecy for the opening wide of my mouth in association with telling us that he gave the false shepherds of Israel their pay in the form of spoiling you of your tithes and of your offerings. He tells us that they were serving him in doing so. They were serving him by helping him keep you in the captivity of Mystery Babylon because you chose to rebel against his word. It is also the first of the 16 days that his servant Hezekiah had Yahweh's house sanctified. The first day of the first month is also the day that Ezra and company departed from Babylon on the 4-month journey to Jerusalem. It is also the day that Ezra and company covenanted with Yahweh to make an end of their putting away of their whoredoms to him. However, you have refused to do both of these at this time. Is it possible that this 188-day warning is just another warning cry that Yahweh is sending me forth with? However, even if it is, his warnings will cease either way during or immediately after the 11-day journey that follows his Day of Atonement, and the Yellowstone melting pot is going to blow forth anyway. This was one of the first visions that Yahweh showed to me when he was plucking me from your midst. And as great as this event will be, it will be just a small part of what he is going to send forth upon those of you that put your trust in your own arm or in your make-believe images that you serve of him that you serve and worship. The Most High requires us to believe him. His word tells us that he is going to cause you to believe him at this time anyhow. He does so in These Are the Truths, chapter 28. If you do not hedge about to do all of the words of this Torah that are written in this book and that are now written upon the whitewashed boulder design of his altar that is in the midst of the 20 cubits by 20 cubits of his house, and you do not fear Yahweh or Elohim's honorable and fearful name, Yahweh is going to accomplish wondrous wounds upon you, wounds upon your seed, great wounds, so that you will believe, and evil sicknesses, so that you will believe. And he will turn back all of the infirmities that were in Egypt to you, and they will cleave to you, and fear will be before your faces. He goes on in the next verse to tell us that he is also going to send every sickness and every wound that is not recorded in this book of his Torah upon those of you that do not hedge about to do all of the words of this Torah that are written in this book and that are now written upon the whitewashed boulder design of his house and upon those of you that do not fear Yahweh my Elohim's honorable and fearful name. All of the infirmities of Egypt include him smiting your firstborns. This is what he means when he says, upon your seed. You won't even obey his word for your children's sake. Shameful. Perhaps you think those 5 188-day earthquakes were not setting up something bigger that would follow in time. It could be that Yahweh might send forth another great warning quake on this one smooth anniversary of his shofar blowing from his holy mountain. Or it could be that the Yellowstone melting pot will be just one of the many great shakings that he sends forth on this day. We will soon see, just 6 days from today. These 5 quakes becoming a 6th shaking parallels his 5th day of the 6-month prophecies that he gave to us in chapters 8 through 19 of his end time Son of Adam prophecies. The 11 days journey that is from his Day of Atonement that takes us to the end of the last great day parallels the 11 days journey from Horeb to the first entrance point of the land of the promise in the days of the first Exodus. Except for the dual men, Joshua and Caleb, our ancestors feared the people of the land instead of believing Yahweh and putting their trust in him and fearing not doing that which he has told them to do. And he sentenced them to die in the wilderness over the course of the following 38 years for their doing so. Yahweh has now sentenced those of you that were 20 years old and upwards as of the first day of the second month to die over the course of the following 38 years as well. He has done so for the same reason. You have not believed him, nor have you put your confidence in his word, nor have you feared him. However, you can still turn back to him and do so. You can do so for your children's sake. And if you do not have children, perhaps you can bring 4 children unto him during these 38 years. Or you can turn back to him and obey his voice in hopes of being resurrected to life at the great white throne. It is what it is. Turn back to your Maker through that which he has restored and put your trust in him and only him and obey his voice, or else prepare to be a recipient of a double portion of his hot indignation. His word says so.